Howdy everyone, welcome back to the channel, and today, we'll be doing an unboxing and review video for the 1/6 scale Gunslinger, the Outlaw of the West figure by Limtoys. But we all know, this is everyone's favorite cowboy, Arthur Morgan, as he appeared in the masterpiece that is Red Dead Redemption 2.
Never thought I'd say this, but it's good to see you, Arthur Morgan.
When it comes to the American Wild West experience in video games, no one does it better than Rockstar's Red Dead Redemption 2. Set in the center of the game's immersive and authentic open world, is one of the most well-written and endearing outlaws, Arthur Morgan, whose epic tale of loyalty and sacrifice had led him to realize that there's redemption to be had despite having lived a life of crime. Released in 2021, this figure actually had a production period of over 2.5 years. While something like this isn't the first time to have happened in this hobby, Hot Toys Pennywise, this unusual delay did cause some to worry, so let's see if what's packed in this little box is worth all the fuzz. Starting with the double feature head sculpts, the likeness to Arthur is downright amazing. The scar by the chin, the subtle hint of stubble, the sheen on the hair, and the details on the beard are all looking very good. Both faces are painted to have this rough and tough feel to them, which suits Arthur's character nicely, as he spends most of his days outdoors. The faceplates and hairstyles are interchangeable. In fact, swapping these out is gonna be super easy.
Barely an inconvenience!
The head can pop right off the neck, thanks to this brilliant peg that Limtoys had even taken the time to label the proper orientation. The hair sculpts are held down by magnets, with ridges guiding the hairpiece down, so they snap right on. The only caveat is that, for the long hair version, you have to manually part these tiny bangs in the well, so they don't get clipped by the ears or scratch up the paint. There's also yet another version for the hair sculpts, this time with a gap by the seams, for fitting Arthur's gambler's hat. This is a signature gear for the character, and thus the telescope crown, the lopsided brim, and that light bit of weathering did not go amiss. Even the ribbon string is faithfully reproduced here with an actual knot. There's also a notch inside that matches the hair sculpt, so it doesn't bump into the forehead. There's even a little wiggle room if you want the hat to sit or angle differently. Before moving on, I'd like to point out that Limtoys had separately released an add-on for this figure, aptly named the Mid-Beard Head Sculpt. Here's a quick showcase, and I figured this might be a good time to demo the hat as well. I love this head sculpt. The scar on Arthur's chin is still visible under this beard. Unfortunately, the harsh lighting here is accentuating the tiny portion of skin between the beard and lips, so the mouth might look a little pouty, but this really isn't too big a deal when you see it in hand. So out of the box, there are 8 unique combinations between the face, hairstyles, and hat. 12 if you have the mid-beard add-on, which is astounding. As for the costume, let's make our way up from the basic shirt and pants, starting with the everyday shirt. The colors, patterns, and even dirty patches by the belly are accurate to the game. It closes with a Velcro, with some sewn-in buttons on the front, so you don't have to worry about scrubbing them off by accident. There's also a band that goes around the crotch, which keeps the shirt constantly tucked in. You also have the option to roll up the sleeves, which goes well with the summer gunslinger outfit. The collar can be easily bent and maintained thanks to the wire within. Even the suspenders have these tiny little clips that make them fully adjustable. They are a permanent fixture to the pants, so they wouldn't unhook themselves when you move the figure around. But be careful not to tug them too hard when you're doing those kneeling poses. And they nailed the tailoring for these work pants too, but the weathering is only found on the knees. And strangely, they look like just a bunch of tiny dry brush strokes. As for these sculpted worn roper boots, the textures, wrinkles, and weathering make these look like legit leather. Limtoys is also covering all grounds here by providing an additional pair of split-cut boots for that extra touch of articulation. The set of Girden spurs will fit snugly onto either pair of boots. What's really cool is that the sculpted leather straps, heel bands, and rowels are all separate components, so there's a little bit of movement between each part. But don't be an idiot like me and lay the figure down on its back with the spurs equipped. I bumped them into the table one too many times, and now one of the rowels is missing. Next, we have a few items that Arthur is seldom seen without, starting with the gun belt and bandolier, which are both made of pleather. The main hand and offhand holsters are a one-size-fit-all, thanks to this clever one-piece design. My favorite, though, is the satchel. It's made from this soft plastic, with sculpted wrinkles and curves, so it perfectly hugs to Arthur's side. And of course, the lid could be opened. But do watch out for this end strap here. Mine fell out of the satchel almost immediately out of the box, and I had to glue it back on, so keep a sharp eye out for yours. There are also some options for the face and neck wears. And believe it or not, with this little neckerchief and all the little things we've covered so far, you can already pull off Arthur's summer gunslinger setup, and this is only half of what the costumes have to offer. The face cover goes on the head by a rubber band. I'm also a big fan of this arsonist and bandit sort of display. Next up are the two outerwears. Starting with the gunslinger jacket, the tailoring here is once again spectacular, and there's a bit of weathering all around. Each sewn-in button has a matching hole on the other side, two flaps on each side representing a pocket. And finally, the pleather collar and the lapel sit really well. It doesn't have that game-accurate tattered look, but I think it's a good trade-off to keep the production quality consistent. The jacket length is just right, so that the knife and gun could be poking out from the holster. I just love how Limtoys has nailed the precision here. And finally, we have the winter shotgun coat. The sharper lining inside is nice and fluffy. There's also a set of matching buttons and hooks on both sides. It doesn't have to be used exclusively here, but Limtoys included a set of range gloves that works well with this coat. And as displayed here, there are two ways to set up this coat. I personally prefer the double-breasted setup on the left. The open button setup on the right is a little hard to manage, as the giant lapels themselves are a struggle to keep in place. But the wires in the coat do allow for some pretty cool comic book style gunslinger poses. For the articulations, this is where I'd usually say, Arthur has the same old boring 6-scale figure joints, but there's a little more this time. Alright, are y'all ready for this? Boom. That's right, Limtoys does not skip a beat, even for minute details that we don't even see. I mean, you rarely even see Arthur without a shirt, but Limtoys went out of their way to give Arthur a sculpted body that perfectly matches the head, arms, and hands. Speaking of which, all the bare hand parts are sculpted to have this tough and veiny look. So instead of talking about the standard articulations that Arthur is clearly capable of, I want to show you this awesome wrist joint that's actually a little slanted relative to the direction of the forearms. I love this design because it makes the locomotion on the wrist very natural. Oh, and the split-cut boots that we saw earlier are actually capable of some very good articulations. I was able to get Arthur to kneel pretty far down, as if he was crafting by a campfire, which makes for a perfect segue onto the accessories. There are way too many. So let's start with the gun that won the West, the Cattleman Revolver, aka the Colt Single Action Army. It's complete with an engraved and textured wood grip, roll marks on the barrel, and a movable hammer and cylinder. You get two of these for those dramatic dual-wheeled cowboy standoffs. Next is a pair of sawed-off shotguns. The details on the wood grain and double triggers are once again excellent. It's also got that true-to-life top brick reload mechanic, so you can actually load these prop shells into each barrel. By the way, there are also some prop ammo for the shotgun and revolver, which you may have noticed earlier on the gun belt and bandolier. Then we have the Lancaster repeater. It's complete with a pleather strap and lever action, the same beautiful wood grain on the stock, and a removable side panel. The sculpted bits in here are actually pretty close to its real-life counterpart too. Sadly, I didn't have much luck getting Arthur to hold this weapon in its proper firing position, as I can't get the hands to point the stock towards the shoulder, so I'm relegated to these reloading poses. Then we have a set of cooking and hunting knives. Each are made of plastic, slightly weathered, and has the proper wood grain and rivets in the handle. Speaking of hunting, there's also a bundle of ropes, which you can shape into whatever you see fit. But this isn't nearly as fun as Arthur's bow, with an accurate but rather rustic handle, and a stretchy bowstring. The arrow is equally rustic, with a sculpted tip and notched fletching, which makes posing the bow and arrow that much more realistic. And for you arsonists out there, there's also a fire bottle with a sticker label, removable fabric wick, and this wavy sculpted waterline. It's such a brilliant touch. And if that wasn't enough to make a statement, there's also a bundle of dynamite that are made of 7 individual sticks. And if you don't want to break them apart, Limtoys has got you covered with an option for 2 individual sticks. As for non-weapon accessories, we are starting strong with this lantern that you can actually turn on by twisting the base, which makes the perfect option for those winter displays. Then we have a deputy badge with a magnetic clip. The sculpting is clean and crisp, and I love the execution here, as the badge can easily go on any piece of clothing. Next is the pocket watch. This is the most basic model you can encounter. Nonetheless, it's adorned with that high-level details on the surface and backing. The label on this pack of premium cigarettes is beautifully printed onto this slightly textured box. I love tiny details like these, which is why this leatherback journal and pencil is my favorite of the bunch. This thing is complete with a manual lock and actual pages you can leaf through, the contents of which are of course accurate to the game. And from the arsonist setup to this journaling pose, this figure is already proving to be too much fun. Next is this jar of flour that Arthur keeps by his bedside. Aside from the journal, this is one item that's truly personal to Arthur, which goes to show that Limtoys is very careful with what to include in this release. And finally, we have a coffee cup and a kettle with a removable lid, a bottle of health cure with a beautiful sticker label, and once again a removable lid, and a display base that might just look like a chunk of dirt at first, but it actually has a portable grill attachment with some charring effects applied to the grate, and a pile of firewood. Together, you can actually recreate an item crafting scene, adding to the already staggering number of display options. For the size comparison, I thought it might be fun to pitch Arthur against some of Limtoys' previous releases, such as this double pack Ahab and Ishmael from Metal Gear Solid 5. These came out around 2018 and 19, but in these few years, Limtoys had significantly improved their level of craftsmanship, and I can't wait to see what they have in store next. So there you have it, the 1/6 scale Arthur Morgan by Limtoys. Not that Limtoys needed it, but I feel that this triumphant release, which took 2.5 years in the making, is somehow poetically similar to Arthur's redemption. And just like in the game, where every granular and methodical detail is celebrated, Limtoys had scrutinized every inch of this figure for the best possible experience, and they nailed it. Ironically, the only major downside to this release is that there's no way to enjoy everything this figure has to offer at a single given time. And the tremendous display options and accessories will keep me coming back to this legendary release for years to come. Thanks for watching, Cowboy, and I'll see you next time.